Hello everyone and welcome back. So in this one, we are going to build an MCP server from scratch. Now we are going to do this from inside the cursor software. This is also sort of like a code editor if you have not used it. And the cursor, we are going to be using it as the MCP host. Alright, so let's get started. We are going to do everything from scratch, which means we are going to set up the environment also, starting from using the UV package. So previously, or in most of the cases, we have been using either conda or pip to sort of manage, install and manage our packages. But UV has become more popular when it comes to the world of agentic AI. So in this one, we are going to start using UV. Now, in order to start using UV, you can go to, you need to first install UV, right? So in order to do that, go to the model context protocol.io. So this is the sort of the home page for model context protocol. And if you scroll down a little bit, you will have the necessary documentation where you can get started. Go to for server developers. So we are going to host, or we are going to create a MCP server, right? So go to this. And if you scroll down a little bit, you will have the command that will show you how to install UV for Windows. So this is the particular command. So copy this. I have run it already, so I don't really need to run this. So open up a new terminal, and we need to be working in command prompt. So close down all the other PowerShells. I'm going to closing it here. All right. So everything is closed. Now paste that command. This will get UV installed inside your command prompt. I'm not going to hit enter and run it because I've already installed this step. Now let's create a project folder. So do UV init and give a name to the folder. We'll call it as words master. Alright, so the project or the MCP server that we are going to be creating does a very simple job. We are going to expose a server that is going to give the number of words for any given text input. Alright, you just give the input in text, any piece of text that you give, it will count the number of words in that text and give you back the answer. That is a very simple MCP server that we can build. We are going to build in this particular one. Now we have created the project folder named Words Master. Now if you go inside this, you will find a main.py file, right? You also have the py project toml file, readme file, and Python version. So now we want to create a virtual environment inside this folder. So what we do, we first cd into the newly created folder words master. All right, now create the virtual environment. We will use uvvenv, so that will create a new virtual environment. All right, now you have another folder created .venv. All right, so this will contain the virtual environment related files. Now we need to activate the new virtual environment. For that, we do .venv/scripts/activate. All right, we need to do a backslash here. So backslash and then backslash. So now you can see here in the bottom, the virtual environment has shifted to Words Master. So we are inside the Words Master directory or the new virtual environment. Now let me clear the screen. Now we need to start installing the packages. So for that, we will do UV add. We need the MCP package, MCP CLI. Alright, we will also probably use the HTTPX. So this will install these packages. It will be fairly quick, so it will install. So everything is installed now. Now we are inside main.py. Here we will need to write our MCP servers. I have already installed, or I have already created this in the past, so I'm going to just copy the contents of main.py in this file. Alright, I've taken this from here. And go to the main.py in the newly created directory, Control A and Control V, so that is pasted everything that we have just taken from the old folder. Alright, so let's go over this. So following are the steps that we will need to use in order to start an MCP server. Now, first thing is we will need to install or import fastmcp from MCP server, mcp.server.fastmcp. So this is imported. We will use this to start the MCP server itself. So this is the command that will create the MCP object, right? So this you need to do. All right, this is the location where the MCP server will be running. Right now, this is going to run in our local host, this particular post, and we are giving a timeout. Now, once this is done, we need to define the functions that is going to be available to the MCP clients. All right, so we need to define the function, and the function that we are going to define here is get word count. So, given any text input. So, this is sort of the text input. Given the text input, it is splitting the text into words and giving back the length of words. So, this is a very simple function. All right. Now, in order to make this into a server, a function that is going to be available for the server, so in order to make it into an MCP tool, to be precise, we need to do two things. That is, you need to add this particular decorator, mcp.tool. Add this decorator and have a very clear doc string that is attached to this function. So, in this case, we have defined just one function, but practically you can have as many as you want. Now, once function is defined, call mcp.run. Alright, so once this is done, let's do a quick checking if this is working fine. So, in order to check that, we will do uv run and call this file, which is main.py. main.py, just to make sure that everything is working fine in this code. So, this is running. Okay, this has not actually run the server. It is showing the previous output. So, probably we need to save this. Alright, and then run the same command again. So, it has started the server and it is seeming to be working fine. Alright, so it is giving out this particular message, starting the MCP server, and that we are seeing here. Now we can close and come out of this, do a control C and it will come out. Alright, so we have come out of this. Now we need to start defining the config.json file. So go to your cursor settings. You can do that using Shift plus Control plus J. Alright, once you are inside the cursor settings, go to MCP. And on the top right, you will have this particular field called add new global MCP server. Alright. If you click this, it is taking you to the config file. Alright. This is the JSON file that we need to update. Now, this is already updated. Now, what I need to change here is the name of the directory that it needs to point to. And that directory is the newly created directory, which is WordsMaster. Alright. And the name of the tool also, I will update it to just WordsMaster here. Right, so this is, and how you read the contents of this file is something like this. So you have the JSON file which contains the details of all the MCP servers that we are hosting. So here we have this particular server, WordsMaster, and it is going to expose the functions written inside the main.py file, the Python file main.py, which is located in this directory. All right, so how to read this is as follows. So, this is the name of the server, and we are going to initiate this server by calling the command uv, and this command is going to take the arguments dash dash directory followed by this particular argument to this directory, alright, and then you have the run command, and you are going to run the main.py file. Now, if you just can simply save this, control S, and go back to your cursor settings, if everything is working fine, I'm going to refresh this. It might take some time, but if you refresh this, you get the details of what tools are available. So, in this file, main.py, we have this particular tool available to us. And in order to run this server, this is the exact command that we have defined inside the command prompt, inside the config file. Right? If you click on the edit again, and go inside the config. So, this is the command uv dash dash directory. Then you have the directory and then run and then main. So, that is the exact same thing that you see here. So, everything is set and the status is green here. Now, what we will do, we can close the command prompt. We can go back to our main here. And we can actually start interacting with the cursor. Alright. So, interacting with the chat. On the right hand side, you have a new chat here. Right. So, just click here and write. So, how many words you can ask the question. How many words are present in the following text. Alright. And then I'm opening quotes. I'm going to go ahead and copy some piece of text here. So, let me copy this. Control C. And paste it here. And let it do the job. So it is starting to generate. I'll help you count the words in that text using the word count function. So it is saying, calling the MCP tool, get word count, which is exactly this particular function that we have defined, or the tool that we have defined. Alright. Now it is waiting for us to accept it. So it is asking a prompt here. Once I click accept, then only it will make the call to that function. Alright. So I'm clicking on accept. And it says it is containing 33 words. And I trust if you break this sentence down into words, right, it should contain 33 words. So I will make this file accessible to you. So please take this and rework the whole thing. Now, in addition to this particular tool, try to create one more tool on top of this, which counts the number of characters in any given piece of text. So you can write a create a new function, get character count, and it takes a text and gives back the total number of characters in that instead of words. So give it a shot. I'll see you in the next one.